How you doing, my friends? I'm the Joven Shire. If you're new to my channel, thank you so much for stopping by today. Hit that subscribe button if you like what you see, because here we cover all things superheroes, movies, video games, and sometimes TV, and that's what we're doing today. We are talking about Punisher because I can't stop talking about the Punisher Netflix TV show. Or, you know, Netflix show, is it can't really call anything a TV show. I'm just excited for the Punisher show. It's going to be very good, or at least it has the potential to be really good, because let's be real and honest right here. As much as we like to say Netflix makes original, great shows, sometimes they aren't that good. Iron Fist, look at the first few Adam Sandler movies on there. Even Defenders, I was kind of like, eh, it's not bad. But I want them to make the perfect Punisher show, because he's one of my favorite storylines in comics. I love a good revenge story, and like the Thomas Jane Punisher movie, loved it. War Games. Was it War Games or was it Warzone? Warzone, loved it. But I do have a strong feeling that Netflix can actually mess this up, and it wouldn't be a stretch for them to do it because they've already done a similar problem with the first Daredevil series. Now, everyone liked the first Daredevil season. It was really good. It was great. It was. When it comes to the Punisher, we've had him introduced in season 2 of Daredevil. People loved him immediately. Jon Bernthal just like hit this role and embodied the character, and everyone was like, oh, no, yeah, that's what the Punisher is supposed to be like. Cool, that's him now. And you know what? I agree. I think he was a great Punisher. I wanted to see some more badassery. I wanted to see more Punisher from him, but that's just me being selfish. And now I get that chance with this Netflix show, even though at the time of recording this, they still have not told us the release date. Most likely, my guess is that they're going to announce it at New York Comic Con, because that is coming around the corner, which, shout out, if you're going to be at New York Comic Con, come find me. I'm doing a panel and everything. Very excited to be there. My main worry going into this Punisher show, because I just want it to be perfect and my expectations are literally like way up here. The one way I actually think Netflix could ruin the Punisher for me personally, and again, it's not that much of a stretch, if they injure him halfway through. Just like in the first season of Daredevil, like Daredevil like halfway through gets stabbed while he's in a fight and then he's like out of commission. And what they're trying to show us is that even with all of the problems, like he's injured, he's bleeding, Daredevil still gets up and he still fights. And that's a lot like his father being a boxer. But honestly, at having a discussion with a friend, we kind of established that it's also easier to film that way. They don't have to spend as much money on action scenes. And then it gives the viewer this sense of like rising from the ashes. This is what a true badass is, because he never says never. But let me tell you exactly what I want from a Punisher Netflix show. Just him going around killing everybody. Somehow every bullet misses him and he's just in there just gruesome, just brutally killing people. That's what I want. Watching the newest trailer, or the only trailer, I like was getting goosebumps because everyone was talking about the knee and headshot where he's like, he's got the gun, he shoots the knee and then turns the gun and shoots him in the head. Like, that's what I want. Tactical, amazing killing. And he just seems invincible. Like, here's the thing. He's a comic book character. He's a vigilante, but he's a superhero. He defies just any realm of believability. And I want that to be the case. I want it to be this scenario where he is untouchable. He is just the biggest badass in the world. I want an 80s action movie, but with like some grit and gore. That's what I want. And I think that Netflix very easily can be like, in his first battle or the second battle, him just like getting shot in the leg, and then all of a sudden he's got a limp for the rest of the series. I don't want that. I want him at 100%, because that is one of my biggest trope in movies, is sometimes you get this character that you expect so much from, or he's a badass character and he's coming back, and then all of a sudden they weaken him for whatever reason, and then he's just not performing at the same capacity. There's an example of that. The only example that's coming to my head currently is Kingsman: The Golden Circle, which I have a review that went up last week, so go ahead, if you haven't watched that, go check it out. But honestly, I don't want them to nerf the Punisher, is what I'm saying here. It's gonna be so easy for them to say, no, he takes a few shots, he's a real human being, he's not Superman, if he gets shot, he bleeds. Like, I don't care. I know that's true, but the thing is, the Punisher, he's a badass, and he just keeps on going at 120%. So show me that. Don't give me a half-assed, weak Punisher, because I don't want it. To me, I'll just be distracted the whole time, being like, oh, he got shot, all right, he's gotta stop fighting now. From what I've read so far about the Punisher show, it seems like it's gonna be a much darker and much grittier version than anything we've seen from the Marvel Netflix universe. I call it a universe, it's still part of the MCU, but, you know, this world. Here's another way Netflix could ruin the Punisher. I swear to God, if the hand is behind anything in the Punisher, I'm gonna lose it. I'm gonna chop off my own hand. No, I'm not actually gonna do that. I get it. The hand is this thing, and everyone in the Netflix verse is fighting the hand. But right now we're looking at a different part of the Marvel universe. We've got the Punisher in there, and he's dealing with the FBI, CIA, National Guard, the Boy Scouts of America. Like, he's fighting everybody. Honestly, I don't want to see more of the hand. I think I've had enough of it. I think when we get more Defenders, I think when we get more Jessica Jones, we'll see more of the hand. Just, I don't need it in the Punisher. Maybe there's a section where he's fighting ninjas. No, don't even do that. I don't want the Punisher to fight ninjas. They don't. Actually, hold on. Because the Punisher going around shooting a bunch of ninjas seems like the coolest thing in the world. Actually, if I remember correctly, I believe that I heard that it's going to be Jigsaw. Jigsaw is his name, which was the bad guy in Punisher Warzone. Warzone? War Games? No, definitely Warzone. It's good to see that we're seeing like a real Punisher villain showing up in this series. I don't know what iteration of the villain. Maybe we see him become the villain. Maybe he's the villain the whole time. I don't know what to expect from the story because the trailer's just shown me a lot of action, and I am not complaining about that. So, my message to Netflix, because Netflix, I know you're watching, right? Duh, because who doesn't, besides everyone, is don't hurt my baby, the Punisher. Just let him go through and kill everyone. And if he does get injured, let's use the Thomas Jane movie of the Punisher as an example. Like, he got beat up by Kevin Nash, like the giant Russian. Like, he got thrown down stairs, through walls. He got beat up. And guess what? He showed up the next day to go and kill an entire house of mobsters. That's what I want. If you're gonna injure the Punisher, that's okay. But it does not slow him down. He's just a killing machine, and he looks good doing it. So, I can't wait. People are starting to put in their theories on when they think the show will go up. A lot of people are saying that it might be after Thor Ragnarok, so that Marvel's not really competing with Marvel. I don't see that as true competition, because they're two very different things on two very different platforms. But some people are saying November 10th or November 17th. They don't think we're going to get it in late October because Netflix doesn't want it to compete with Stranger Things. And yeah, honestly, if they came out the same weekend, I do not know what I would watch. But maybe you can tell me in the comments below, what would you watch, Stranger Things 2 or the new Punisher show? Also, do you think I'm stupid? Do you think I'm crazy here? What do you want from the Netflix Punisher show? Do you think that Jon Bernthal, man, I have a hard time with his name, is going to be a good Punisher again? Nah, come on, we already know he is. Don't even waste our breath on that. Just, let's talk in the comments below, because that's why I do this. Again, guys, if you're new to the channel, I'm the Joven Sharon. Thank you so much for watching this video. If you liked it, hit that subscribe button, because I'm going to tell you, if you like this video, you're going to like the other videos that I do here. So till the next time, I'll see you later.